But let's discuss what the long-term opportunities for this market are. We have our alpha manager now, Sohini Adnani, the fund manager of SBI Mutual Fund, who joins in to discuss a lot of opportunities that this market throws up, especially in the mid-cap and small-cap space. She runs the SBI Magnum Mid-Cap Fund, and in a bit we'll get you some details of the kind of returns that this fund has given as well. Sohini, hi, good afternoon, and thanks for joining us. You know, your fund has given a return of more than 26% in the last 5 years, 27% in the last 3 years, and almost 20% in the last 10 years. Do you see a lot of opportunity in the mid-cap space now over the next couple of years? And if yes, what are the pockets or sectors that are, that are seeing a lot of interest now?
The mid-cap segment as such has seen a sharp rally in last 3 years, and the stocks have re-rated in expectation of a strong earnings recovery led by the overall economic recovery.
Sure, go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, so the returns from here in the segment would be dependent upon the strength of the economic recovery and how strong the earnings recovery is actually. As the PE re-rating to a great extent has already happened. So one will have to be watchful of, how strong the earnings recovery continues to be while the expectations are already been built in. And as far as the segments are concerned, I think it is across the board. It is in each sector you have pockets and companies which keep doing well over a period of time. So it is more broad-based opportunity, and generally in an economic rebound, it is not only sector-specific themes. It is across the board recovery in the mid-caps that you see.
Okay. Sohini, hi. Good afternoon. You've been known for contra approach in the market for last 3 or 4 years. What are the best contra opportunities available in the market right now, where you think the consensus could be getting it wrong?
I don't know whether I can call myself a contra player per se, because we have been playing growth as a strategy in our funds, and I think that is well accepted in country like ours, which is growing at one of the fastest rates globally, and you have an enough opportunity to grow into mid-cap space, even in large-cap space, but more so into mid-cap space. Across the sectors. So we are not particularly chasing any particular sectors here or theme here. The idea is really to look for the promoters and companies which have been investing for the future growth. They are doing the right thing, which will give them the growth during next 3 to 5 years, and generally businesses which can generate good cash flows and capital allocation is efficient. And this could be across many sectors actually.
Okay, so we're just going through your Magnum Midcap Fund, and over there you have a relatively high exposure to the NBFC space with names like Cholamandalam Investment, names like Bajaj Finance, and we've seen the way these stocks have performed, right? Most of them are sitting at fresh highs. Do you still see more value here for retail investors?
So the sector has done very well in the last year or so. I think it's got significantly re-rated. This is also because some pockets within the NBFCs, like a CV finance segment, which has started to see a pickup, because CV volumes started to pick up and the growth has kind of picked up here for last 12 months or so. Also, the fact is that the asset quality issues, though they were there in the NBFCs, these were far more better managed vis-a-vis some of the asset quality issues that the corporate financiers faced. When the interest rates are coming down, they do get the benefit on the margins from the lower cost of funds. So I think there are a lot of factors which contributed to the positive expectations, and the companies have been, and these NBFCs have been relatively well managed, and they have delivered on their expectations. So I think what we have seen is that the earnings have seen some rebound, plus we've also seen a lot of PE re-rating. Now, if you look at the loan growth is still not very robust and it's been moderate, and there is a possibility that the loan growth can pick up over next 12 to 18 months. There is no signs of immediate pickup from here, but over a period of time, as we get into a positive cycle, that is, that is something that one should look for. However, we believe that a lot of PE re-rating has happened. So from here on, again, the stocks will behave in line with what kind of earnings growth that they can deliver.
Okay, so any the other stock that I can see in your Magnum fund, mid-cap fund, which has done well for you, of course, is Dr. Lal PathLabs. I'm assuming you would have taken this call at the IPO time. We have seen a lot of IPOs in this space. Do you see diagnostics emerging as a big sector going forward? And would, in that case, would you like to invest in the names like Thyrocare, etc., going forward, apart from Dr. Lal that you already have in your portfolio?
So, I mean, I think it's a part of the pharma portfolio overall, and how we are looking at the sector as a whole and maybe a diagnostic industry as a part of it is that generally the pharma sector, we have exposure to pharma stocks across in the portfolio, and not only the particular stocks that you mentioned, but we have been investing in this segment because the companies have been doing a fantastic job there. The sector has been facing some challenges of late because of the heightened regulatory activities by US FDA, and which is causing the challenges for some of the companies, plus coupled with the fact that there is a consolidation in the distribution in the US, and that is also putting into some pressure on the pricing. So I think while the US opportunity still remains very good because of now the faster approvals coming in, we looked at diversifying our exposure to the domestic segment, to the domestic market, which I think with the pickup in the economic activity, as the personal income levels go up, there is a huge potential for these industry in our country. I think the penetration levels are quite low, and these businesses are very scalable in terms of you can expand you can expand very fast by improving your reach. If your management setup is well settled, and some of the larger diagnostic companies are in that position today, so I think it was from our need to diversify to a non-US market where we wanted to take an exposure. So diagnostic was one, and we've also taken exposure to other stocks which are having a non-US market exposure per se. So I think it's part of the overall pharma strategy, I would say.
Okay. In your blue chip fund, I was just going through the kind of stocks that you have, and you hold on to Titan. This time, the company's numbers were quite weak, both in the watches and in the jewelry segment. And to be fair, some of these traditional brands like Titan are getting hit by a lot of disruptive technology, a lot of competition as well. Would you keep the faith with names like these, or would you rethink your stance on some of these stocks?
Definitely, I think the industry is witnessing a lot of challenges, but we believe that Titan is poised well for the rebound in the discretionary consumption, and is part of the theme that we are playing on the discretionary consumption side. So we would look at it more from that perspective into investing. And I think the challenges from the new way of doing businesses are present today across the board for many of the businesses. I think some of the companies do take up this challenge and gear their business model to suit that kind of challenges, and we would be positive on companies which are able to do that.
All right, Sohini, thanks a lot for taking time out for us and talking to us. It was a pleasure. So that's Sohini Andani, one of the fund managers of the two funds which have done remarkably well over the last 2 or 3 years. But let's move on and talk.